The Kenny Dillingham experiment is just over a month in now, and we know quite a bit about our new head coach, and we're here to discuss everything that we do know for sure on this edition of the Locked On Sun Devils podcast.
Our Locked On Sun Devils, your daily podcast on the Arizona State Sun Devils. Part of the Locked On Podcast Network, your team every day.
LinkedIn Jobs helps you find the qualified candidates you want to talk to faster. Post your job for free at linkedin.com/lockedoncollege. That's linkedin.com/lockedoncollege to post your job for free. Terms and conditions apply. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Locked On Sun Devils podcast, part of the Locked On Podcast Network, your team every day. My name is Richie Bradshaw, and I will be your guide for everything Arizona State Sun Devils. As always, thank you guys for making us your first listen of the day. Remember, the podcast is free and available on all platforms, including YouTube. If you want to check us out in a visual platform, wherever you're getting your podcast, though, hit like and subscribe and turn on those notifications so you get an update when we post new content. Stay in touch with that content by following me on Twitter at RichieBrads36, and you can get the podcast as well at LO_Sun Devils. Guys, we are doing some speed dating right now with Kenny Dillingham. That's the best comparison I can come up with, is we have truly gotten to know Kenny Dillingham in a very short amount of time. Now, there's some things that we did previously know about him before he became the head coach, right? We knew that he was a Valley kid. He grew up in the east side of the Valley area, I believe, but he grew up in Arizona, went to Arizona State University, graduated in 2012, was with the coaching staff as a grad assistant in the 2014 season, I believe, and then followed Mike Norvell over to Memphis. He spent some time with several teams as an offensive coordinator and a play caller before eventually winding up back at Arizona State to be the head coach of the football team. These are the things we knew already. When he had his press conference, we began to hear what he's about. He began to sell himself to us, right? It's part of the dating process. When you're getting to know someone, you need them to tell you the things about them that are necessary to know before you decide if you want to attach yourself to them long term. So the fans have to listen to these press conferences. They have to listen to what Kenny Dillingham is trying to put out there. And he's telling them things, you know, we're going to activate the Valley. That's one of the biggest things he says. He says, we're going to recruit in Arizona. We're going to bring in transfers. We're going to do all sorts of things to make Arizona State University one of the more marquee programs in the Pac-12. These are the things he told us. These are the things he sold to us. These are things that so far he has stuck to. This is one of the first things I want to note when we talk about what we know about Kenny Dillingham. Dude's a man of his word. Kenny Dillingham has delivered on what he is about right now. He is out here selling. He's backing up what he was selling. That's what I'm trying to say. So with Dillingham, he tells you he wants to activate the Valley. What does he do? He starts recruiting in Arizona. He starts getting more high school commits. He starts getting kids that were from Arizona high schools and didn't commit to Arizona State University, that went to other programs around the country, enter the transfer portal, and now they're coming back home. Guys like Jacob Conover and Jake Smith, among many, many, many other players, decide that they're going to be coming back to Arizona State, where maybe they could have been the whole time, but we'll never know. Bottom line, Kenny Dillingham is delivering on his promise. What else is he doing? He's getting people to buy in to what he's throwing out there. And when I say buy in, I mean literally buy in. The Sun Angel Collective, which is Arizona State's NIL cooperative, whatever it is. It's not a company. It's like a non-charitable kind of thing, I guess, is like the closest thing I can think of off the top of my head. But the Sun Angel Collective, which is supposed to give opportunities to Arizona State athletes to make money through NIL, name, image, likeness. People are buying into that. People are buying the packages that they have, and people are supporting the program in a way that the Valley hadn't previously supported Arizona State. That's huge. You also have a lot of people on Twitter that are saying, you know, hey, I renewed my season tickets. I am looking forward to spring camp. I'm looking forward to the scrimmages, stuff like that. They're reaching out on Twitter and saying, you know, I'm excited. I'm excited about what's out there. It's all because Kenny Dillingham is backing up what he's saying. When Kenny Dillingham said he was going to activate the Valley, clearly he meant it, because people are buying in. People are literally buying in, and they're figuratively buying in. When I say figuratively, I'm talking about the people that are saying they're excited for Arizona State Sun Devils football. The people that are willing to start coming out to the games and make it out to practices and other events that the football team might be putting together. You've got those people that are willing to do these things now because Kenny Dillingham is empowering them to do so. It's part of what makes him an easy guy to root for, but that's neither here nor there. The biggest thing that we know about Kenny Dillingham right now is that this dude is absolutely a man of his word. You have to appreciate somebody who can deliver on what they say, because as my great-grandfather used to say, you're only as good as your word. And right now, Kenny Dillingham's word means quite a bit, and he's absolutely delivering upon it. Meanwhile, these days, every new potential hire can feel like a high-stakes wager for your small business. You want to be 100% certain that you have access to the best qualified candidates available. That's why you have to check out LinkedIn Jobs. LinkedIn Jobs helps find the right people for your team faster and for free. It's super simple, super easy to do. You can post your job for free in minutes. Once you do that, add your job and the purple hashtag hiring frame to your LinkedIn profile to spread the word that you're hiring. Simple tools like screening questions make it easy to focus on candidates with just the right skills and experience so you can quickly prioritize who you'd like to interview and hire. And at the end of the year, there's never been a more important time to have the right crew. It's why small businesses rank LinkedIn Jobs number one in delivering quality hires versus leading competitors. LinkedIn Jobs helps find the qualified candidates you want to talk to faster. Post your job for free at linkedin.com/lockedoncollege. That's linkedin.com/lockedoncollege to post your job for free. Terms and conditions will apply. As always, guys, make sure that you are making the Locked On Sports Today podcast your second listen of the day. The biggest stories around the sports world in 20 minutes or less. Instant reactions, game recaps, and of course, the take of the day. Locked On Sports Today, available on YouTube and wherever you're getting your podcasts. Back into our conversation about the things that we know about Kenny Dillingham. Remember I said he's a man of his word? Part of the reason why he's a man of his word is, holy cow, he just hit the ground running in a full dead sprint. And I feel like that is still not even putting it properly to words. He wasted no time at all getting Arizona State back on the right track. Right now, according to 247sports.com, Arizona State has the number 6 transfer class. I have seen some places that have them with the number 1 transfer class. They have gotten all the way up to the 44th overall ranked class in terms of commits, both through the transfer portal and through actual high school recruitment. And they are the 65th composite rank. This is a school that was somewhere in the 90s last year with Herm Edwards. That is a huge turnaround in just about a month's worth of time for Dillingham to actually be putting his work into practice and building up this program again. That is insane. The amount of progress that they've made in such a short amount of time. And major props go to Dillingham for being able to do this. And he's done it in all sorts of different ways. Like we talked about in the previous segment, he's done it through actually getting people to buy in very literally with their cold hard cash to the program and deliver to NIL opportunities for these kids. He's done it through being able to reach out to the guys on this team and sell Arizona State to them again. Look, here's something really important to think about. Arizona State has had, I believe, 16 kids enter the transfer portal. That's a lot of kids, but it probably should have been a lot more. And it probably should have been a lot more high-profile players as well. But that hasn't been the case. The biggest reason why is because Dillingham is able to sell himself, sell what he's wanting to do with the university and move forward. These kids were not recruited by Dillingham. They do not owe him any allegiance. They don't owe him any of their time, nothing. If they want to move on because the group that actually recruited them is gone, it's no longer Herm Edwards' team. That's who brought these guys in. Herm Edwards and Antonio Pierce were the guys who brought them in. Neither of them are at the program anymore. They do not owe Kenny Dillingham and his staff anything. They can leave if they want. They can move on to greener pastures and get bigger NIL opportunities or contend for national championships or anything else that you could possibly think of. But they're staying. Guys like Elijah Badger and Jalen Conyers and Trenton Bourget and Tevin White and Roe Torrance and Connor Soley and Carter Brown. The list goes on and on of major contributors from last season who are staying with the program right now. They're not leaving. In fact, you've had some guys like BJ Green and Anthony Cooper straight up pull their names out of the portal and say, yeah, you know what? Actually, I do want to stay. I do want to be a part of the change and figure out what the next steps are. Who knows? Maybe some more of the kids who are in the portal right now decide to do the same thing and withdraw their name from the portal and come back. But Dillingham has worked so quickly to reestablish the identity of Arizona State as a competitor and as a good program. Look, I have said many a times on this podcast, and I will continue to say, this is not a university that is got a standard for competing for national championships, like an Alabama or Georgia or an Ohio State or a Michigan. That's not us. Instead, we're just looking to be competitive. 8-9 win seasons, compete for the Pac-12 sometimes, go to bowl games, bring in NFL talent. Dillingham is already reestablishing that image that was starting to get a little bit murky with the Herm Edwards era. We are back in the good graces right now. And it's insane how quickly Dillingham has been able to establish that. You don't overnight, you're not supposed to at least, go from the 90th ranked recruiting class somewhere in that ballpark up into the 60s in the composite and the 40s in the overall and sixth overall for the transfer class. That's not supposed to happen like that, but it has. And it's because of Kenny Dillingham activating the valley. The dude works fast. It is unbelievably insane how quickly he's been able to reestablish everything that we've come to know and love about Arizona State. He's done it in the blink of an eye. It's mind-boggling how quickly he's been able to get everything back on track. And I can't put it else to words. It is truly mind-boggling how quickly he's been able to act. And it doesn't feel like he's going to be slowing down anytime soon. In fact, it feels like things are only going to start heating up and getting more intense for Arizona State as the Kenny Dillingham era continues to establish its roots. But he built his staff in just about a month and was able to start bringing in recruits almost immediately. Signing day comes around. You have 15 guys who are signed their letters of intent. You have two more hard commits. And then you have, what did I say it was? 18 guys transfer, which included today, Bram Walden, offensive lineman for Oregon, is committing to the program, in case you missed that. Dude is just, like I said at the beginning of this segment, he hit the ground running in a dead sprint, and it just feels like there's absolutely no slowing down Kenny Dillingham right now and everything that he's planning to accomplish and will continue to accomplish with the program right now. BetOnline is your number one source for sports betting info, news, and analysis. Get the latest odds and trends for every professional and amateur league out there, from pro football to college bowl season and basketball. We've got it all at betonline.net. If you love sports podcasts, you can even find those at BetOnline as well. We're always the fastest and easiest way to get your betting info. So head to the website today or use your mobile device to learn more about the trends in action happening right now at BetOnline, where the game starts. One more time, thank you guys for making the Locked On Sun Devils your first listen of the day. Remember to make the Locked On Sports Today podcast with Peter Bukowski your second listen of the day. Get the analysis and opinions before anybody else with our local and national experts and insiders. Locked On Sports Today, available on YouTube and wherever else you're getting your podcasts. The final thing that we have come to know about Kenny Dillingham: the future is bright at Arizona State University. Again, I want to continue to emphasize, the expectations are not national championship at Arizona State. Heck, more often than not, it's not even to win the Pac-12 every year. Again, it's to be competitive. It's those 7, 8, 9 win seasons. It's putting in some NFL talent. It's winning bowl games. It's recruiting. It's building an image and building a community within this university. Arizona State competes in every single sport. So football isn't the biggest priority for the university. That could change with Dillingham, the way that he's building up this program right now. I'm not making promises that it is, and I'm certainly not going to sit here and tell you that that is exactly what's going to happen, because there is still so much that we don't know yet. But what we do know is that Dillingham is intent on turning Arizona State into a competitor a lot sooner rather than later, mind you. Kenny Dillingham seems dead set on turning Arizona State into an absolute powerhouse program. And he's doing it right before our eyes. It won't be long before the first 5-star commits to Arizona State. It won't be long. It could be this week. It could be in a year. It could be in 2 years. But it's going to happen with Dillingham. I guarantee that 100%. He is going to pull a 5-star recruit. Based off of what he has shown me already, I know that a 5-star is only a matter of time. Is it Dylan Raiola, the quarterback? Is it tight end Deuce Robinson? Both Arizona kids. There's definitely been an emphasis on pulling in Arizona kids. That's all I'm saying. But the future is bright. I truly believe that Arizona State is going to be back to a bowl team next year. I don't know if I see like a 10-win season. I think an absolute best case scenario is probably an 8-win year. They've got a very tough schedule coming up just in the Pac-12 alone. But I wouldn't be surprised if Arizona State is back winning football games in 2023. I truly think that Dillingham has just got us on the right track right now, and that we're going to be reaping the benefits of a good football team. Again, like, sounds like a broken record, but sooner rather than later, Arizona State is going to be back on track. And it's because of the time and effort and energy that Kenny Dillingham has put into the program in such a short amount of time. It's remarkable. We don't see these things happen. I truly can think of very few examples where a program was just magically right back on track because of a hire. That's the direction that Arizona State's going right now. And who knows? Maybe Dillingham gets you to that national championship contention. I'll hold my breath. Not because of Dillingham, but simply because the program has just never been that. Who knows? But Dillingham has me believing right now that anything is possible. Call me a hopeless optimist if you have to. But if you think that I'm being insane, go back and listen to some of the other podcasts where I was a negative Nancy about this team. Okay? I am embracing being a fan 100%. And I am definitely a lot more excited than I probably should be and need to learn to temper my expectations a little bit. But it's hard not to when Kenny Dillingham has tipped his hand and showed us exactly who he is in such a short amount of time. this is a guy that is a program builder. I am already thoroughly convinced of that. There is nothing in this world that I believe to be less true than Dillingham is going to rebuild this program. I'm all in. Consider the Valley activated. I'm not the only one. We'll go ahead and wrap it up there. As always, thank you guys for tuning in. Remember, wherever you're getting your podcasts, hit like and subscribe and turn on notifications so you get an update when we post new content. Stay in touch with that content by following me on Twitter. You can find me at RichieBrats36. You can find the podcast at LO_SunDevils. Until next time, you keep it locked right here on Locked On Sun Devils.